Most of you have GitHub profiles that look like this. If you are a victim, don't worry. In this tutorial, I'll teach you how to transform your GitHub profile from looking like this to like this. We'll be using free resources to transform our GitHub profile. So follow this tutorial to the end and transform your GitHub profile in order to stay ahead of your tech game. Ready to do it? Let's dive into it. In order to get started, open your favorite web browser and open your GitHub repository. So this is my GitHub repository being opened, and from here, open another tab and search this particular word. So search for GPRM, okay? GPRM, which stands for GitHub Profile README Maker. So this is what we'll be using to transform our GitHub profile. So click on the first link and this will open the particular web interface where you can transform your GitHub profile. So over here, the first thing you need to do is to enter your GitHub username. So you can come back here and look at your GitHub username. And over here, you can see my username is Felix-Sam. So I'll just copy it, come back here, close this ad, and then I'll paste it right here. From here, I'll click on button here. And this will take me to this page. So on this page, you have to write about you. Okay, so you have to just write about you, what you do. So you can see there is a template here. So I've already written that in a note. So I'll just open this particular note and copy whatever I've written. So you should also make sure you write about you and just go back there and paste it in here. All right, so after this, you can click on next. Over here in this tab, it will automatically load your stats from your GitHub profile. So whatever you want it to be on your GitHub profile, you have to just go ahead and select it. So over here, I would like my lifetime commit to also appear. So I just click it. My private commits, if you want them to be visible, you can also click on this button to make all of that visible. All right, from here, in case you are good with these settings, you can click next. Also, what you can do is to change your border. So you can change it to this, or you can put it back, which I will do. You can also change the theme. So you can change it from dark to radical. You can change it to any color you want. So I'll choose radical in this case. So I'll click on next, and this will take me to the social media links. So over here, you have to provide links to your social media handles, okay? So I've also done that in my notes. So I'll just copy this link and I'll paste them right there. So I've linked to my Discord. I'll just go back in the browser, locate Discord and put this right here. I'll go back and do it for each of these social media handles. So let's do it for Facebook. Go back, locate Facebook, which should be somewhere here. I'll do that for Facebook. Now let's go to LinkedIn. Don't forget to add your LinkedIn, it's very necessary. So I'll also do that same thing for my LinkedIn profile. Then finally, I'll do this for Twitter, which is now known as X. So let me go back here and search for X and put it right here. From here, if you have a YouTube channel, you have to put it. You have a Twitch account, TikTok account, you just have to put all of those things here and then you can click next. Okay, so hit on the next button and this will take us to this page where you have to choose or select your tech stack. Okay, so over here, which languages do you currently know, which of them do you use? So you can just go ahead and select them. For now, just select a few of them and put them there. So let me select Python is also here. HTML5, I'll do that. I think that's pretty much it. Then you come back to hosting, which cloud services do you use? So you can choose all of them and just continue. All right, so you go back down and over here, you have to also select the frameworks or libraries you use. Okay, so there are pretty plenty. So just go through it and select all that you use. I'll quickly go through it and see. I don't think I can see all of them anyways, but I'll select as much as possible that I use. So move down here and some of these, you can choose some of these servers that you use. Then from here, you come back to your databases. So which of these databases do you use in your project? Which of them do you know? So you can just go ahead and choose all of them. You scroll down and here design. So design over here, which of these design do you use? If you don't use any of them, you can just leave it. Then we have machine learning and deep learning framework. So over here, you can just go ahead and choose them. If you use them, you know how to use them, you choose them and that's it. There are other things you can choose. So here I'll choose GitLab, GitHub. Which other one have I used before? Git is also here, so I'll choose it. And I'll come down here and other stuff. So these are other stuff. So I'll choose Arduino, I'll choose Docker, and Kubernetes is also here. So I'll also choose that one as well. And I think that's pretty much it. So you guys can go through it and choose all the ones you have been using. Okay, so just take your time, go through it and choose the ones you have using. After that, you just click on next. Okay. So from here, now, if you want people to donate something to you, you have link to your Patreon, you have PayPal, Buy Me Coffee, you have any of those links, you can just put it here and it will appear in your GitHub profile and people can help you by donating something to you. So over here, I'll just put the link to my Patreon and I'll just paste it right here. So this is the link to my Patreon. And from here, I just have to click next. So now this is the page where you choose to display all your achievements, your trophies. So here I'll just click on add GitHub trophies. I'll also allow background. You can change these colors if you don't like, but by default, I'll leave this. And here you can add a programming code here. So never trust a computer, you can't throw out a window. So I can add this particular quote here, which will also appear in my GitHub profile. Then from here, you can see some of the Mustard repositories are also here. So you can also add them to it. And finally, you can press next. So you can customize this to your liking. Okay, I'm just showing you how to do it. All right, so now we have the profile design. So this is how it will appear on your GitHub. But how do you make this appear on your GitHub? So that's the next thing I'm coming to show you. All right, so now you have to go back to your GitHub and make sure you copy this, your GitHub username. So you can see Felisam is mine. So I'll just copy Felisam over here. And the next thing you have to do is to create another GitHub repository. Okay, so that GitHub repository is where you'll be pasting your code you get from what we have designed, and you just paste it there into a readme file. So I'll click on repository and then I'll click new. From here, I'll paste my username here, Felisam, and you can see what they are saying. Felisam is a special repository that you can use to add a readme to your GitHub profile. Make sure it's public and initialize it with a readme to get started. So you scroll down and make sure this is public. So public radio button is checked and click here to add a readme file. So that's all, and hit on create repository. This will create a repository for you. And then over here, just have to click on edit readme file. This will load, and right from here, just go back to where we've prepared this particular GitHub profile and click on copy code. Okay, you can also download the markdown file, but just click on copy code, go back here, and then highlight all of this code with Control plus A and press Control plus V to paste the new code in here. So right after pasting this, just click on commit changes. So commit changes, and this will commit the changes, and this is now how your GitHub profile looks. Okay, so this is looking amazing now, and this looks so well. So when I come back here and I refresh, this should change and my GitHub profile should now look a little bit better and well organized. So that's how you can transform your GitHub profile from looking something like what we saw from the starting to something like this. Okay, so guys, this is it. This is my second GitHub repository that I use for personal things. So in your professional GitHub repo, you have to consider changing this image, put up a very nice profile image, and you can also add some additional stuff to it. So this is how you can customize your GitHub repository to look better. If you like this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe. Also share this tutorial with one of your friends so that they also make their GitHub profile look better like yours. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.